expect to have you here. So, Chinua, at school, at the very end of the school year, when everything's getting all dried out, did we look for some seeds? Yeah, we did. In fact, that's where you guys collected these wonderful tree seeds, these manzanita seeds. You guys collected these onion seeds. So many seeds that everybody collected. Now let's think about this, okay? From the very beginning, remember we started up the globe, and we said we had minerals on our earth, we had water on our earth, we had an atmosphere on our earth, and then we had sunlight, and all four of those things are what every human being and every living creature needs to have. So, I want you guys to think backwards. You've gone through the whole process of planting your seeds, watching it grow, maintaining your garden, eating the good stuff from your garden, and now you're at the point where your garden has given seeds, and it's time now to put your garden to bed. So what you're going to do, you're going to take the seeds, you pull out anything that's all dry and brown, and where you put it? In your compost, exactly. And then, actually, you take that and you recover that back up in your garden, so when it's really hot and no one's growing anything, you cover it all back up. What's happened to the microbes and the cellulose inside your garden? Well, they can be dormant, but if they have water, what's going to happen? All summer long, they have chomp, chomp, chomp. All summer long, while you're not using your garden, they're going to make in good soil. So the last thing we do when we put our garden to bed is we bury or cover back up every single thing that we grew. But before we do that, we're going to collect our seeds. Now, I want you guys to think about the opposite. Now, in order to grow, the seeds need to have what? They need to have water. They need to have food. They need to have air. And sunlight. How can we store our plants so they don't have those things? Because our seeds. Because we don't want to have our seeds sprout. How can we make it so, what's the opposite of light?
Dark.
So it needs to be dark. What's the opposite of water?
Dry.
Moist. Dry. It needs to be dry. Okay, so what's the opposite of having food for them to eat, having soil?
Mm-hmm.
Having no soil, right? Okay, and so what's the opposite of having all kinds of air circulating around?
Just like
airtight. So we're going to do the four things that we need to grow. We're going to do the opposite four things now to collect our seeds. Isn't that wonderful?
Mm-hmm.
It's just so simple. Here's how we do it. We're going to recycle. Now, what you guys see me? We did. What did we do with this? You missed that. We did a soil test first. It was so fun because we had to see how much sand was in our soil, how much caliche was in our soil, how much organic matter, so we could know how to amend it. And that's what we did the first day. So we're going to recycle this jar. We already used this. Well, we already used this for two things. We used it when we were demonstrating compost, right? We used it when we did our soil analysis test, right? So now we're going to keep reusing this, and we're going to use it now for our seed collection. All right. So in order to get those four opposite things, we've got to have something that's dry, airtight, dark, and what else? And no soil. No soil. Okay. So here's how we're going to do it. Okay. Now, you guys can do this at home. You can take any container at all. And it's a good thing. Whenever you guys have something, if you eat something, you think it's, that's good. Peach. You got a really good peach pit. Here's what you do. You stick it up on your shelf and let it dry out. When it's nice and dry, you put it in one of these little jars. Let's see. What else do you guys have? What else do you find some seeds from? And some nice organic seeds that you might like to eat. May I borrow your pen? Draw my pens outside. Okay. Now what do we have? Let's see. What do you guys? How about apples? Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah, any kind. Yeah, you know, in all kinds of fruits and veggies, you guys are going to find really, really good seeds. How about, let's say, if you guys have some good almonds that aren't cooked and you want to save those, you want to reuse those, or maybe some good sunflower seeds. There's all kinds of things you guys can save. And now you're really learning how to grow. You can experiment with growing virtually anything. It's a wonderful experiment. Okay, now, I made this the same size, right? So I'm gonna do it like this, put it right inside. Now, why am I doing that, you guys? So, now, to make it really dark, I better put something on the bottom, right? Okay, now, you can use, if you have construction paper at home, you can use dark construction paper, but it doesn't have to be black, you guys. Because actually, the paper blocks out the light. Okay, let's see, we've got this one. I'm gonna get each one out of the two presses. The three of you guys, I want you to cut these out for me. Okay. You may notice that these are folders, quite frankly. Did I get these from your classroom, Ms. Glenna?
I don't know.
I may have. did you have Ashley? I think I got this from Miss Jovine's classroom for the Montessori education program. Okay. Now, I'm going to put this right in here. Go ahead and give everybody the scissors. Okay. You know what? I got this a little big, sweetie. Can I use that scissors just for a second, sweetheart? Made this a little bit big. You guys, why don't you cut on the inside of the line so it's a little bit small? Because I think I made it a little bit big. Oh, there you go, sweetie. Now, it should fit. Aha! It does fit. Good. Now, look at this, you guys. It's clean, right?
Yeah.
Is it, did you see any food in there, any dirt? No. There's nothing for the plants to eat, right? If I close it up like this, it's going to be really dark in there. Is there going to be light in there? Okay, if it's closed up tight, is there going to be any moisture in there? No. So, this is a perfect thing to put your seeds into. Now, you want to make this a little bit smaller, sweetheart. Now, let's see. I'm going to have Miss Sammy. Okay, these are some of our garlic and onion seeds. Now, if you can break those up. To break these up. Aha, see the black guys coming out? Okay, go ahead, yeah, put them in there, good. All right, now let's say the first layer she wants to have that's yummy, yummy garlic. That smells so good. Okay, layer number one. Okay, you want to cut some more of these out, sweetheart. Go ahead and cut. I'd like to have another three of these. Come here, honey. You want to help me? Okay. Perfect. And then make them a little small, you guys. Okay. And let you know cut himself one too.
Yeah,
perfect, dear. Okay. Now, Sammy put the garlic in here. Okay. You know what? You guys. You know what? I think we need to make these a tiny bit smaller because we want to have paper between each one.
Oh, I see.
That could absorb any moisture at all. So we keep them separate. Now, because seeds look alike, here's what Sammy's gonna do with that. Sammy's gonna write garlic on this, okay? Go ahead and write garlic there. Where's the pen? Here's the pen. Write garlic there, buddy. G A Oops. R. Just gotta hold it up straight, sweetheart. G-A-R-L-I-C. You guys think of making small, they can be a little small, the inside of it, okay?
It's okay.
Well, we'll push it down and fit. Oh, there you go. Garlic. We'll push it down so now we know. Now look, you guys, she knows she has garlic seeds under there. Now, would you put in, thank you, your sweet pie. Now, why don't you write down, okay, you pour in some oats. These are whole rolled oats. You put in some oats, okay? Okay, now, write oats there. Oh. Go ahead, you want to write Hey, let me borrow your pins, ladies. So she, yours are, these are manzanita. M-A-N-Z-A. N-I-T-A.
M-A-N.
It would help to teach you how to spell it. Help them. You must start spelling it. Buck brush.
Buck brush?
Yeah.
Is that one word?
It's one, but it doesn't matter. Okay. He's ready. Chinu is ready. Right, bump brush on this kiddo. Can you see it? Now, go ahead and put your onions. Put your onions in there, sweetheart. Onions. Okay. Pour them in there. Good. All right. Pour in your manzanita beans. Stick it in there.
Buck brush.
Yeah, buck brush.
B-U-C-K.
B-R. Chinua is going to close it up tight. Go ahead and close it for us, Chinua. Good job. All right. Now, Chinua, you want to put this on the very top of. Is everything on the very top?
No.
Okay, good. All right. So you guys can keep layering these. Isn't that neat? All right. Yeah. You know what? Let's put this right in here. Yeah. Dark and dry. Even though it's cool and dark and dry in here. Where would be a good place to store those? The refrigerator could work.
The basement.
How about, where else do you think? What do you think, Angel?
The basement.
A shelf. Yeah. A dark shelf. Yeah. In your kitchen. Yeah, it's not going to get too hot there. It's going to stay nice and dry. It's going to stay nice and dark. That's a good place. Yeah, you can even put it in your closet. Not bad. Okay. So, all right. We now have an adorable little thing of shit. Now, you guys, can we blow some kisses to these seeds? Because it really is true. My grandfather, everybody in the whole country used to come and get their seeds from him because he loved them and they grew. He just, everybody knew. You get your seeds from Grandpa Poker because they're really good to grow. Conditions under which she took off her coat. I want you guys to think about this. Once our seed took off her coat, once our seed grew, go ahead and grow. Once our seed made her own flower, made a big flower, and then once our seed made her very own seeds, the question is, how then could we collect her seeds so she could grow next year? Okay, come here for a second. Have those seeds stick up here.
Okay.
Good, here's a little seed. Here's what I would do. I take some seeds.
Out of there.
You are exactly right. Let me
show
you.
Can I show them? Please. Can I show them?
Students, can you guys look? Look at this beautiful flower. This flower is nice and soft. Can you see? Miranda, can you see? But look at this flower here. It's really dry. Look how dry that is. So, once she made her flower and it's all dry, show us what does happen with your seeds.
You pull this out.
Look, you guys, look at that. Look how many seeds she has. Isn't that neat? Look at all those seeds. Every single one of those could make a flower. Now, if you'll scoot back, students, just a second. I'm going to show you how we store these seeds, okay? Now, you know, you got to tell me, what did the seed need to grow?
Soil, water, and sunshine.
And sunshine. So the opposite of that is what we need to store our seeds. Let's think about it. So in order, the opposite of sunshine is what?
Dark.
Dark. Look, you guys. Here's a jar. We'll put this right inside. It's
dark. Now, we need to have, oh, look at this, what do you think? Do we need something else to make it dark?
Yes.
Okay, all right. What am I going to do? Okay. Watch what I do, you guys. Two pieces of paper. Now, I'm going to take my scissors and cut all the way around. Let's put one circle in here. And now it's dark. I put a seed in.
She's filming.
Put the sunflower. Is that my daughter? Now, look at all the seeds here. Now, here's a nice, really dry one. You want to pull these seeds out?
You don't have to mind my business.
Look at those. Every single one is grown to a flower. So, put yours inside. This one's inside. So when we go outside, everybody gets to pull their own seeds. Now, I want to show you one more thing about seeds. Okay, let's try this again. Secret number one. The seed wears a coat. Secret number two. The seed has a plan. For how it's going to grow. Secret number three. It carries its own food. You know what I forgot before? Put this back on. You know, you guys, remember you said she needed food for the root? Remember the root to go down? Put your lunch under here. There you go. And then she needs food enough for the little shoot to go up. Put your lunch in here. She's got all this food. So when she gets water, go ahead and water her. And when she has some soil, now, where's my sunshine? When she has her sunshine, Gracie, you ready?
Andrew, you're the sunshine.
Okay. Shh. Now she starts to open up. So she needs to eat her lunch, doesn't she? All right. That's what she needs to grow. So, different seeds have different amounts of lunch. She has two big lunch boxes for this great big seed. Here's lunch box number one, and here's lunch box number two. Now, this little seed right here is small. Do you think it needs such a big lunch?
No.
Let me see. Let's see how big a lunch this one is.
Yes. Big for that seed.
Look at this teeny tiny lunch seed right here. Look at this, you guys. Look. That one just has a tiny bit of food that it eats. And this seed right here, what is this, you guys?
Sunflower.
Let's see how much food this one packs. How much lunch it needs to have. Look at this teeny tiny seed. Do you think that packs very much lunch?
No.
Okay. Now, let's see. I want to show you one of the smallest seeds of all. Move, honey.
Oh, I know these seeds.
This looks like dirt. Look how tiny that is. Does that pack a lot of lunch?
No.
But it has a coat, doesn't it?
Yes.
And it has a plant. So every single one of these are totally unique. So, when we go outside, okay, everybody, watch again, you guys. Everybody is going to pull out their own seeds outside. Darby. Miranda. Everyone is going to put their own seeds inside the store. Miss Carol, you want to put this in your science area and show us where this is going to go? Now, this will stay dark and dry and cool, and these seeds can last for like years. Did you know that some seeds can last, like if they're in good conditions, like what we said. What is this? Dark, dry, and cool. Seeds can last for like thousands of years. Isn't that amazing? If they have those conditions. Okay, where do you want to store these on your science shelf?
Well, I don't think you should put them outside.
Okay, they probably have to stay. No, if we put them outside, what's going to happen?
They'll be warm. Too warm.
So, do you have a side shelf that you can put them on?
Because black attracts the sun.
Yeah.
We'll probably put it over here when I can get
okay.
it.
Okay, all right. Now, do you want to choose the number of students that are going to go outside and get their own seeds outside?
Okay. You were ready to take all of the third graders, right?
Okay. Third graders first? Okay. All right. So you guys go ahead and line up. There are different molecules within their plant. And they pull up different minerals from the earth, and different minerals help them to build different colors. Okay, you guys. So while we're going outside, could you students help me put all these things back on the shelf? Okay, here's the scissors and the pen. You might get yours all ready.
Look, Miss Heather, look what we have. Look, Miss Heather. Look at that.
That's amazing. You have enough for a whole field of flowers.
Whoa! We do? Yeah. Where's that? We can do more. Look at mine.
I love those. You know, I'm wondering, there's a different kind of seed you can make. Look at those. You guys are being really careful, so you're only taking the run, right?
Yeah.
Good. Well, you got the whole thing, don't you?
Look at these.
Oh, look at that. Oh, look what she found. Oh, she found a different kind of seed. That's what I wanted to show you guys. Look at that. That is so neat. Oh, push up, Miss Bella.
Little bubbles.
Okay, show her the seed pod, Carrie. Look. Guys, look.
Whoa!
Isn't that neat? If you see any really dry parts on the flowers, yeah, see? It's like a little seed bubble.
That was a good
one. Okay, isn't that neat? There's more inside. I'm going to show you.
Here from the tomatoes.
Fell. Now look at this one. Okay, look at this one. This is so neat. Look, let's see this whole. This is a dry. This is a seed coat. That's a dry coat.
Whoa!
Are we ready?
Are we ready?
Oh yeah, we're rolling.
Okay, now look at this. Okay, now I'm gonna slice this. Okay, I opened it up. Oh! Whoa. Oh! Those teeny tiny ones
like
here.
A little vanilla
isn't that
bean.
Neat? Here.
Look at these. Can we have them?
Yes, here. I'm going to give you some. You can slice them yourself.
Yay.
Well, I think maybe I better slice them. It's really nice, it's too heavy. But can you just be really, really careful?
Yeah. Well.
Okay, I don't want anybody to get hurt.
Where should we put these?
Started. Isn't that neat?
Where should we put these?
You can put them inside.
Now.
Put it on the ground.
Might be some more over here too. If you look at any of the flowers and you see dried pods.
Hey, I found a coconut.
Did you?
I have stick coconut.
Here?
Look at that.
That is so go show that to this fella. Look at that, isn't that amazing?
What is it?
Look, here, show it to Miss Bella. Show it now. Now look so she can see that. Looks now hold it so she can see those little three seeds. It's a baby coconut. Isn't that neat?
Oh, that's cool. Wow. You see it?
Bella. Bella, she found those for her palm tree.
Don't move.
What you do before she gets started? Look. Okay, wait. Now you scoot back. And then you do like this, okay? So do it gently so it doesn't hit you in the eye. Okay?
Hit it a little harder.
Don't
look
move her, I won't get the shot. Hold on.
That. Is that neat?
Where'd it go?
Okay, you want Mary the Grace? Camera to see?
Hi, Gracie. Look at that, you guys. That's wonderful. Oh, these kids are putting so many.
Kari,
things.
Hold it like this and hold it real like still. Back up. Right there.
Can I help? Well, can I do one? Oh, are you okay?
Yeah.
That is a coconut.
Wait, Kari.
No matter what the age or no matter what the activity is.
Ow! This is a coconut!
Can I use it, Miranda?
I know! Yeah, look at mine! You can see it better!
Oh yeah,
that's Miranda's.
Can I see that?
Uh-oh. Here, can I do it? No, Miranda,
is that a coconut?
It after. These ones are mine.
Can I do it after you?
Put these in ours.
Okay. Miranda, your mom's here.
I love it.
Hi, Mom! Okay. We're cracking up our coconuts.
Coconuts, oh yeah.
And the coconuts cracking them up too.
With the milk
isn't that,
in there?
They've been doing seed collection. Sure, you should see the seed she collected. It's just incredible.
Really?
Hey, what happened tonight?
Ah!
Can I use it?
$2 seeds.
Okay.
Can you help me because I was trying.
I found it.
You know what? I think maybe better. Those guys are so hard. Did you do it? You almost got it.
I just need to take.
Hey, Miranda. My mom's
here. No grabbing.
Ooh, yeah.
No grabbing.
Ooh.
That is so good. Now, those girls.
I think that's good enough. That's as good as you can get it.
Remember, I told you there are some seeds that can stay dry and cool.
Oh, I found a dry one.
And dark.
for like, and they can last for hundreds and hundreds of years.
Whoa.
Isn't that amazing?
Oh my gosh, that had nothing in it.
Three skins, look at that. Oh gosh, Miss Bella, look at this.
Three skins.
Now, think about this. These guys grow in a desert. Makes sense. How did you all work? Now, you want to go get a piece of tape?
Okay.
Ask for a piece of tape, and you're going to write your name right on the front, okay?
Okay.
If you pull this part off right here, look, that's a little seed. Look, can you see that teeny tiny seed? Now look
I
at this here.
Look
at the thing. Hold it like this. Okay. Hold it. Hold it. This will grow into a whole big plant like that. Here.
I see this little bit.
Yeah. Isn't that neat? So look, so in our whole garden, every single one of the things that we're growing in our garden comes to this last stage of making seeds. So, let's see. Now, here's another kind of seed. All right. Can you guys see the seed right here?
Yeah.
Now, if I would break this open, let me see.
Okay.
All right. Break this open. Look, Cole, look right in here, honey. Look. There's a seed right in there. Look at that tiny seed. Can you see?
Yeah.
You see that, sweetheart?
Yeah.
Look at where it goes.
Now, okay, there's another seed I want you guys to look at. Look at this one.
I didn't get to see it.
Could you scoot back, sweetheart, so she can see?
I didn't find that other pineapple.
You guys, look at this. Look. Okay, look what I'm going to do. This little cup here, this little sepal cup right here, if I pull it open like this, look what's in here. Look at that. Look. Can you see that black seed? Look at that black seed. Isn't that neat?
I see it.
Do you see it? Isn't that neat?
I didn't get one.
Oh. So we may think this flower is completely past the most beautiful stage because it's all dry. But it's at the most beautiful stage. Yeah, the stage now to make seeds. When you pull your seeds off, collect your seeds. Okay, look at that. Wow, look at all those black seeds. That is so neat. Look at all those.
I got a lot.
Here. Yeah, I'm going to give each one of you. Open this up and see what's in there for a seed.
Do we put it in the cup?
Yeah, and then put them in the cup. Okay.
Look what I have.
I'm going to grow some
look at what I have. Look,
okay, now I'm going to give each one of you guys, did you put some seeds in yours, Joe and Justin?
What's this?
Okay, now write your name on the bottom of the cup. Write your name. Yeah, look at that. Wow. You guys can grow those next year, but what would happen right now? Okay, let's say we have our seed cold. If we put Ethan into this dirt to grow, and it's very hot outside, and there's not enough rain, what would happen to him? Would he grow?
No.
No, he wouldn't grow. He wouldn't grow. So we have to save these so they're nice and dry, and they're in the dark. Here's your cut. Okay, you guys, okay. Now, I cut a piece of paper. We need to make sure it's nice and dark and dry so they're not going to grow, okay? So, you put your cup, put this paper right in here. What, Daisy?
I don't have a pencil, but some
sugar.
Here,
just take one. One in there. Okay.
Make sure it's really dark.
Now, we got to make sure it's really dark. So, is it going to be dark if I have a hole like this?
No.
Nope. So, I have to do it like this. I've got to get one on the top and one on the bottom. Okay.
What do we have to do? Like these pencils.
Write your name on your cup. Because I want you to be able to have your own seeds that we're going to plant in the fall.
All right. Where are you supposed to put them? I'm going to be in my trading cup.
Okay, you put your cup in there first. Is your name on there? Now look, it's dark. Can you see? You can't see through there now. Okay. Put your cup in there. Okay. You put your cup in. You put your name on there.
I don't want
Can
my
you put,
name.
Put the pencil back, honey.
My pencil won't even show. You're going to have your own seeds. Oh yeah, can I bring mine home?
Nope. We have to store these, honey. Could you put this in here?
My cup had a squash in there.
Okay.
Can I have my squash seed bag?
Here's some.
I'm going to give each one of you guys a squash seed. Paul, would you put the lid on this? Put the black lid back on the top. Okay, good. Now, it's going to be really dark in there. Look how dark that is. I think I need to make this a little bit smaller. open. All right?
Look at this.
So, put the lid back in there. Now look at that, you guys. So, when it's time to grow again next fall, this is going to be completely dry and completely dark in there. And the seeds that you guys gathered, you'll be able to plant.
Hold it right here.
You gonna smell those?
Ethan, let me smell them. Let me smell them.
So when we cook next week,
oh, they smell good.
So,
I want to see.
Right, right there.
Can I see? Oh my God.
Okay, aha! There's one right here, you guys, look.
I
can't get it, let me see. Now,
whoa!